Hey everybody, Nathan Fowkes here. So I really like doing these kinds of doodles in my sketchbook, just playing around, making an interesting little idea or an interesting composition. And one of the things that is even more fun is to take the ones I think have a little tiny bit of potential, and like I'm doing here, crop them, scan them in, take them into Photoshop. And a few of you have asked about, well, what does the process look like? And so here's a little demo for you. So I took that sketch and I made a selection of all the darks and all the lights. One of the nice things about doing that is that it holds a little bit of an organic quality and a little bit of the texture of the paper. And that way the sketches don't feel so digital. They don't have some of the artificialities that the digital tools can sometimes create. So I'm going in from there and painting over top of that, glazing a little bit, because this is some kind of creepy guy, I don't know, kind of pushing through a curtain, maybe a little bit of the Phantom of the Opera kind of a vibe here. And so I have this intensive blue light behind the curtain, rim lighting shining through, casting a diagonal shadow in there. I think the diagonal is important. It gives it a little bit of creepiness. Diagonals tend to suggest action rather than something more passive or stable. And so I'm double checking to make sure, you know, which kind of blue do I want? A warmer blue, meaning going towards the purples? Do I want more of a cyan blue? And so I kind of struck the balance there between the hue and the saturation on that rim light, keeping it pretty light and pretty cool, but not too saturated. A little bit of a hit on the color of the shirt there for focus, to really draw attention to that particular area. And I'm turning my selections on and off, as you see there, because I do want to hold on to that texture and I want to maintain some of the shapes that were working, I think, in the original quick sketch. But I also want some transitions, a little bit more subtlety. And so I'm just using soft brush. I'm not using anything fancy here. I think I have a standard Photoshop chalk brush going to lay down some of those streaky organic textures, and just a soft airbrush. I'm also just making a little tweak to the head of the guy, as if his head is bowed, as if he's pushing through, you know, kind of leaning into the curtain. Tiny bit of character pose, but I'm more worried about the dramatic impact in the color, the shapes, and the composition, just for a little tiny super quick mood piece. All right, so that's really great for me, just to keep my chops going and have a new idea every day. So if you'd like, you can check out my online classes and tutorials at schoolism.com.